Oh, hello there. I'm Nemo. Duck, dear Nemo. Got it? Hey, what are you doing?
Dumb duck. Welcome to Quack, a new format where I will answer all your scientific questions. What does Quack stand for? Quick, useful, and amazingly cool knowledge. Let's do this. Why are some deep water fish bioluminescent? Surely it's counterproductive and just makes them easier to hunt. The short answer is preying, defense, and communication. You know how some fishermen use luminous lure to fish? Well, that is because some organisms are attracted by light. And the same technique is used by predators like the anglerfish, which has a light organ to attract its prey. Another example is the stoplight loosejaw, which is a fish that emits red light from under the eyes. You have to know that red is a color that most deep sea animals cannot perceive, but the loosejaw can. The loosejaw hunts with a beam of light that is invisible to other animals. Some animals use bioluminescence to confuse their predators by showing flashing patterns or by squirting a cloud of light. Others use bioluminescence to camouflage. Yeah, camouflage with light. Let me explain. An animal that is in a dark environment but where to steal some dim sunlight can use its bioluminescence to disrupt its own shadow. To do this, it uses light organs on the ventral part of the body, which emits light at the same intensity of the dim sunlight. Also, in a completely dark environment, the only way to communicate visually is by using light. Bioluminescence can be used for recognition, but also to attract males for reproduction. Oops. Why are sea slugs so pretty? Oh, sea slugs, also called nudibranch. They are the Pokemon of the sea. This one looked like a bunny, and this one looked like Pikachu. But why are they so colorful? Here too, I can identify three reasons. The first one is called aposematism, and it's when an animal shows conspicuous colors to communicate to its predators that it's not worth attacking or eating. In fact, many nudibranch are toxic, and it's really not a good idea to eat them. Secondly, camouflage. Some nudibranch live on corals and anemones, which can be very colorful. By adopting the color of their environment, nudibranch can become invisible. And thirdly, some non-toxic nudibranch imitate the colors of toxic nudibranch so they would not be attacked or eaten. Can sharks really smell blood from miles away? No, that is a myth. And if you think about it, it doesn't really make sense. When you are smelling something, your chemoreceptors are detecting something real, molecules. And it works the same way underwater. Imagine there is a drop of blood 1 kilometer from you. Not only you will have to wait until at least one molecule travels to you, which is gonna take a long time, but the probabilities that even one molecule reaches you are essentially zero. If you assume that the blood will travel to you through the process of diffusion, then the drop of blood will be diluted in 2 million tons of water before potentially reaching you. The equivalent of one drop of blood in 14 billion drops of water. Sharks have a very good smell, but I'm sorry, they cannot detect that. Do you guys have scientific questions you want me to answer? Just drop a comment right here. See you next time for another Quack.